Welcome to the fifth and final part of the tutorial. Now we will create a travel request process for our travel request app. In the App Composer page, click on the plus icon in the Process Builder. This will launch the Process Builder. The main panel in the middle is the graph canvas that contains the actual process diagram. Click on the Edit icon beside the process name in the navigation bar here. This opens up the Properties panel where you can edit the process details. Rename your process to a more meaningful name, such as Travel Request Process. Participants represent users or roles that perform a certain task. Click on the participant to set its properties. Let's name this participant as the requester. Add more participants into the process by dragging a participant from the left palette. Then, name our next participant as the approver. All right. Let's craft our process diagram. All we need is an approval process flow to approve and reject requests. The green node here represents the starting point of a process. Hover over it and drag to choose the new node to create. Add activities, tools, subflow, and routes into the process diagram. Ensure that all process flow paths have a proper start and end. And once you're done, add a red node at the end here to indicate the end of the process. To handle routing for approval as an example, we used the diamond-shaped route node. Then, in the transition after the route, we can define conditions for the process flow path. Click on the route, then on the right panel, click on Mapping, choose Simple Rules. Click on Add Condition, if status is equal to approved, then transition is set to Notify Approved, else Notify Rejected. Click on any participant to map the participant to specific groups, users, organization chart, and so on. Let's quickly map our requester and approver participants here. Click on any activity to map it to a specific form. Map the submit request activity to our previously created travel request form. We don't have a form to handle request approval yet. Let's click on the plus icon to quickly create a new request approval form. Fill in the new form details accordingly. We can make use of the existing table name. Click on the button here to open the approval form in the form builder. Remember to rename the section. Let's rename it to Travel Request Approval. In this new form, add a subform of form element to display the submitted form and a radio button form element to capture the approval status. Configure this subform to select the original request form. configure the radio button and add approved and rejected options. Remember to map the radio button values to the status variable so that the variable can capture the selected value and flow to its configured process path. Preview and save the form. Next, click on any tool so that you can map that tool defined to process tool plugins. For example, to send out an email, we can map this tool to an email tool. Excellent! Our process is ready. Click on Save on the top right here to save the process to the server. For your information, to quickly test out your process, click on the Run Process button along the top here if you want to. We will now incorporate the process into the UI. In the App Composer page, click on an existing UI to launch the UI builder. Create a new menu category. Drag a Run Process element into it. This menu element allows end users to start a process from the UI. Edit its properties and select our newly created process. Now drag an inbox element into a menu category to provide users with an inbox to manage their assigned workflow tasks. Drag in a list element too so that we can show the list of travel request records. Remember to save the UI. Now, let's try to go through the travel request process in runtime. Excellent. This is the end of the 5-part tutorial on building your first app. Thanks for watching.